My name is Lisa Moore, and my novel is called Caught. It's the story of two Newfoundland guys in 1978 who decide to import the largest amount of pot ever imported into Canada. And it's a story about freedom, and it's a story about youth and the vulnerability of youth. And I wanted, so my main character, David Slaney, breaks out of prison and heads across the country of Canada, and he's traveling underground because the cops are hot on his tail, and he's heading toward Vancouver where he'll meet up with his friend Hearn, and they're going to head down to Columbia and try to do this again because they've already tried once and were caught, and now they're going to try it again and try to right the mistakes that they made. But unbeknownst to them, the RCMP in Canada have invented a new technology, and it's satellite technology, and that means that their entire trip is tracked the entire way across the country and down into Colombia. And so for me, the novel is about, it's kind of like the story of Eden, the great fall, because and has a mythic quality, because I think in 1978, importing pot was a kind of innocent affair. It was the moment just before the drug wars became really ugly and violent, and you know, the drug lords in Mexico and Colombia took over. It was a kind of innocent romp, but these boys were made examples of. And in Newfoundland, because there's a little bit of a, based very, very loosely on a true story. In Newfoundland, these guys became sort of folk heroes. It seemed like they were trying to cut out the middleman and just go for broke and just be on the ocean and experience the wildness of that. But it's a moment when everything is changing, and they are being watched by a new technology, and it's a technology of surveillance that we all live with now and have become so used to. You know, every time we use a credit card, all of our actions are traced, and every time a child goes to school, you know, the corridors are being videotaped, and so we've grown used to that technology. But it was sort of the moment when everything changed. Well, I'm going to say Kathleen Winter's Annabelle because she's a compatriot of mine, a Newfoundlander, and because the book is very radical. It's about a transsexual, and but it's also very beautifully written and elegant and full of passion and life and survival in the North, and it's well loved by anybody who reads it.